Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, in the laws of carrying out an item that is worn as a garment or an ornament. Says the Kitzur today, Mitpacha shemekanchim b'yas ha'af. A person has a handkerchief which they use to wipe their nose like a tissue. Noigin lekarcha tachas abeged ha'elyon. The custom is that they should wrap it around their waist using it like a belt. We're talking about a large handkerchief over here. He's using it like a belt to hold up his pants. Al mikhnasayim, on his trousers. V'yizor shel alaseis b'shnei ksharim. But of course, when you tie that, make sure you don't tie a double knot, because that would be a problem of kshira, of tying on Shabbos. So you do it in such a way that I guess it's going either around the top of your pants or through the loops itself, and you're using it as a belt to hold your pants up. Says the Kitzur, V'yirei Shemayim, however, a person who is God-fearing, Imunayig Lisa Ritzuas HaMachzikais Es HaMichnasayim. If a person wears straps that hold his pants up, otherwise known in Yiddish as Hoizen Trager, which means suspenders, Yisirim B'Shabbos, you should remove the suspenders before Shabbos if you plan to use the handkerchief as your belt. Because if you have suspenders, so then you don't really need the belt to hold you up your pants. So therefore, if you need to carry a handkerchief, make sure that it's being used as the belt, because that is what is holding up the pants, and that the suspenders are taken away. That's what I say, because if you need to be able to make sure that the handkerchief is serving a purpose. Some people have the custom of tying the handkerchief around one's neck. But that's not permitted. Unless you don't have another scarf that's around the neck. And a person sometimes, he will wrap himself with a scarf around his neck because of the cold. And of course he has to tie it again, not a double knot, one on top of the other. He has to tie it in the right way. However, if he just takes his big handkerchief and he puts it over his neck, and he ends up hanging out in front of him, he didn't tie it in a way that shows that he's trying to keep his neck warm. The issagam, but that itself is a prohibition. So to tie it around your leg or your hand, and go out in the shoes of Rambim, all of that is also, that's prohibited, because that's considered carrying. You're not wearing it as an ornament or a garment in that case. One more halacha over here. But the Yadayim, what about wearing gloves in the Rishus HaRabim on Shabbos? Yesh matirin lotzeis ben b'Shabbos. There are those who say you could go out with them. V'yesh oisin, those who say you cannot walk out with them. And the reason that you would not be able to walk out with them is we're afraid that you might take them off in the Rishus HaRabim. Maybe a bug got somehow inside and bit you and stung you, and it hurts, and you want to examine your hand right now in the Rishus HaRabim. And you'll end up carrying Dalet Amos, you'll end up carrying those gloves in the Shus HaRabim. However, you have what's called a muff. You have an item that was designed to heat up both of your hands at the same time. Yesh lahakil tvei, there you can be more lenient over there, because if you have both hands in this big muff, so even if you would get a mosquito bite or a bee bite or whatever it might be that you need to examine your hand, so your other hand is holding the muff in place, and we're not concerned that you're going to be carrying it. Dalet Amos in the Rishus HaRabim. Have a wonderful day.